Dear students, in this class we will discuss the important test to distinguish alcohols, that is Locas test. Locas test. What is meant by Locas reagents? It is a mixture. Locas reagent is a mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride. This is the reagent. Locas reagent is a mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride. And this Locas reagent is used to distinguish primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. Now let us see what is going to happen when this Locas reagent is added to these three types of alcohols separately. Primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol, these are the formulae. RCH2OH, CH2OH is primary alcohol, CHOH is secondary alcohol, COH is tertiary alcohol. In three test tubes, you are taking these three and simultaneously you are adding Locas reagent to all these three at a time. What is going to happen? Let us observe. In the case of tertiary alcohol, soon after the addition of Locas reagent, a white turbidity is formed, white precipitate rather better, white turbidity is formed just within 30 seconds. That means almost immediate. So, tertiary alcohol gives white turbidity immediately after the addition of Locas reagent. Within 30 seconds, the result is obtained. In the case of secondary alcohol, it also gives white turbidity, no doubt. But it gives white turbidity within 5 to 10 minutes after the addition of Locas reagent. It does not give the precipitate immediately. And in the case of primary alcohol, no precipitate at all because there is no reaction at room temperature. You have to take here at room temperature, you are taking the reaction. At room temperature, primary alcohol doesn't give any turbidity, even though you are keeping that mixture for a long time. There is no reaction at all. And that is why there is no turbidity. See, this is how these three alcohols can be distinguished one from the other by using Locas reagent. Right? Why is this happening? Tertiary alcohol is giving white precipitate immediately. Secondary alcohol is giving later, after 5 minutes, and primary alcohol doesn't give any precipitate, even after a long time. What is the reason for it? In the examination, how to distinguish means, it is better to write this up to this extent only. But what is the reason for it? Let us know the reason for the immediate action of tertiary alcohol and no action of primary alcohol when Locas reagent added. Please note it. Now let us know the reason why is tertiary alcohol more reactive and reacting fastly with Locas reagent. Locas reagent is concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride. Acid is there, strong acid is there. So it can be treated as a strong acid. Mixture of concentrated HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride is even more stronger than concentrated HCl. That is the fact there. That is only due to the formation of zinc acid. Acid with zinc complex. Zinc complex acid will be formed there. H2ZnCl4. And here, you are taking first alcohol. Any alcohol you can take here is less acidic than water. This is the fact. And here you can take the decreasing order of acidic character for alcohols. Water, of course, more acidic than methyl alcohol. Methyl alcohol is more acidic than primary alcohol. You can take your RCH2OH. Primary alcohol is more acidic than secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohol is more acidic than tertiary alcohol. This is the order. This is the primary alcohol, this is secondary alcohol, this is the tertiary alcohol. And of course, this is methanol. So out of all these alcohols, methyl alcohol and ethyl alcohol are more acidic than the remaining secondary and tertiary alcohols. So this is the fact. And that is why primary alcohol gives reaction with sodium, giving you sodium alcohol oxide, because it is more acidic. But less acidic than water, the reaction is very slow. But in the case of tertiary alcohol, it won't react much easily with sodium, because here, due to the three electron releasing groups of alkyl groups plus inductive effect, the COOH bond will be taken place easily. That is why it is not acidic. It can be considered as basic. As is, this is the least acidic among all these, this will be more basic. And so, if you take the basic character of these alcohols, primary alcohol is less basic than secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohol is once again less basic than tertiary alcohol. This is the reason. So, out of all the alcohols, tertiary alcohol is having more basic character. More basic character, relatively. This is only relative comparison. And this is less basic than tertiary alcohol. And this is the least basic. As it is least basic, it is unable to give the reaction with the concentrated acyl also, or low-cost reagent also, at ordinary temperature, don't forget. Anyhow, even this primary alcohol also gives the test, low-cost test. It gives white turbidity only at heated condition, high temperature. Heated to high temperature, this also gives the precipitate. That is why the condition is at ordinary temperature. At ordinary temperature, low-cost reagent gives immediate test with the tertiary alcohol, slowly with the secondary alcohol, and no reaction at all with primary alcohol. This is the reasoning. Because of the more basic character of tertiary alcohol, it is reacting fastly with low-cost reagent, and it is a less basic character. Secondary alcohol is reacting slowly with low-cost reagent, and as it is having least basic character, this basic character is not sufficient to bring the reaction with low-cost reagent at ordinary temperature. Okay, this is the reason. Now let us put down the equations. Please note it. Now let us consider the reactions. First, I am taking tertiary alcohol like CH3, CH3, OH. This is tertiary butyl alcohol plus HCl in the presence of anhydrous zinc chloride. Here, as this is having a more basic character, this fission will be taking place easily. And so, it will be converted into H2O, and OH is replaced by Cl easily. And that is why you will get here CH3, CH3, Cl plus H2O. 2-chloro-2-methylbromate, this is tertiary butyl chloride. This is insoluble water almost, and so it is obtained in the form of white turbidity, white precipitate. Within 30 seconds, don't forget. That is the case with tertiary alcohol. And you can take here secondary alcohol also, CHOH secondary alcohol. This is isopropyl alcohol. This is secondary This is tertiary. Right? Once again, you are adding HCl in the presence of anhydrous zinc chloride, that is nothing but a low-cos reagent. The fission of the CH-OH bond, CO bond, takes place slowly because this is less basic. It takes time. And therefore, the fission becomes slow. It is undergoing slow fission here. This fission is very slow. So OH group is dissociated slowly. CH-OH bond, CO bond is undergoing fission slowly. And so H2 is removed and this is replaced by Cl. And that is what you are getting here. CH3, CL plus H2O. This is what you call isopropyl chloride. Once again, you are getting this white turbidity, white precipitate or turbidity within 5 to 10 minutes. This is the case here. So in this way, primary alcohol, if you take primary alcohol plus low-cos reagent, this also gives reaction at very high temperature, but at ordinary conditions it won't give. No precipitate at all at 30 degrees centigrade. But primary alcohol also gives the reaction with low-cos reagent provided it is heated to high temperature. So this is how you have to take the reactions. Secondary alkyl halide is obtained, which is also insoluble almost. It is obtained as white precipitate or white turbidity within 5 to 10 minutes. This is the way you have to distinguish, and this is the secrets behind the reactions of low-cos reagent with alcohols. Okay? That way low-cos reagent can be used for distinguishing alcohols. In the next class, we will take some more reagents to distinguish organic compounds one from the other. Thank you very much for your kind hearing. Thank you.